It's me, Mario!
So this is Super Mario 64 70 Star, which is basically the bare minimum to beat the game without any major skips.
Yeah, so like no LBLJs or anything like that we'll be seeing in this room. Oh yeah, and this is Washi, I'm Saiyans. Right there, he skipped a lap or two. There's a bit of dialogue, he just skipped. So, how many seconds does it save? Like,
eight?
Yeah, 8 seconds.
Realistically, in this game, you basically go for the fastest stars in 70 Star. Like, there's no point going for most of the 100 point stars in every stage. And most stars are generally on the top of 30 seconds.
Yeah, so this run's very fast paced. It's quite amazing to see 70 stars start in like less than an hour.
Here we go!
Sexton. Alright, so he's gonna be doing Cannonless next. A year and a half ago or so, there was a setup discovered for this. You used to just run up against the wall, but now there's an entire setup done. So here it is. Excellent.
Here we go!
So yeah, usually for that star, in vanilla playthrough, you actually have to break the wall with a cannon shot, and then go collect the star. But yeah, it's really easy because there's actually a pixel of the star that you can grab.
Yeah, so it's very precise. But with that setup, it makes it like more consistent. Yeah, you can still not get it sometimes, though.
Here we go!
So as you can see, like, very fast stars here. There's usually a cycle he'll run through, but if he has delayed movement, he has to, like, do backup strategy quite often.
Great hit collision in the old game of Mario 64.
Yeah, yeah, that's right, eh?
Here we go!
Hit the switch plus grab the star before touching the ground, you actually skip the text for the wing cut. I think it saves about 3 seconds or something.
As you can see, the movement he's doing, he's usually trying to get on the faster side of possible on things. So yeah, it's very important that he's doing this for us. Oh yes, I'm back up straight away. As an example, he would have done those two red points there in the other order. Third cycle.
Little animation glitch you can hear on the Japanese version of Mario, where you grab the key, you just turn Mario's body a certain way, and it stays stuck like that.
Yeah, I thought it was a dab on Thursday night, and he never thought of that. Oh, that's alright.
Yeah, completely intended there, obviously.
Yeah, it was in our intentions. It's alright, you can back it up. Yay.
Yeah, so ideally I'd want to land on the ice platform and just jump dive to the star. If you fall down, it costs you about 3 to 4 seconds. It's not too bad, but it doesn't look really good, obviously.
No way, dude. Yeah, we get this one out of the way.
Thank you.
sneaky little bugger, isn't he? It's a nice speed tech though. Knowing me, I would have grabbed him and like ran him across the bridge and down the hill and around there. Seen there, there's quite a bit of lag in the N64 version, so often Washi's like during the run having his camera in particular angles to reduce lag.
Actually have to do a bookcase puzzle, or that's the intended way, but because this game just mechanics are broken, you can use its normal tech that they give you and just completely jump right into the star.
Yeah.
Okay, so what I'm trying to do here is actually use the bomb to creep into the pyramid. It saves activating all four pillars with the shell. So if I can get it this time, it'll probably look really nice.
Third time's the charm.
Saves about 15 seconds from grabbing the shell and actually riding it around all the pillars.
Yeah, pillars. Wicked trick. Not easy at all. There, he just, you know, lava boosted up to a higher platform. Yes, gets like very specific height just to get up to that higher platform,
there. Here we go.
I was punching off the stairs. There's quite a few cool tricks you're going to see here in HMC, but I'll let him focus.
That wasn't quite optimal, but you can see this level is actually quite broken because you can jump over the boundaries of the map, and for some reason you load the other room once you get around there. So that skips getting the metal cap at any point in the run, and it's nice and easy using Mario's downwards velocity from that wall kick. Here we go!
I think I hit once.
Thank you.
enemies can sometimes just not detect. They have really poor hitboxes. There we go. I mean, ideally you don't want that to happen in a run, but sometimes it does and there's nothing you can really do about it.
Very good RNG there. Yeah, the RNG in this run is often the coin spread when you break boxes. And as you see there, they're all doing very well so far.
Yeah!
As you can see with most stars in this game, it's just pure like platforming, so there's not very many glitches or clips. The next stage will have a couple of them, but yeah, there's not really many in the whole run.
We have an anonymous $15.75 donation. There was no message attached, but thank you very much anyway. It's going to a great cause. Thank you.
Yahoo! Yahoo!
There's actually a lot of lag in the area on this star on Nintendo 64 because it just can't handle every item that's on the screen.
When he rides along the wall though with the shell, it actually speeds him up a little bit. Just if anyone was curious, like, why he's doing that.
So after this next star, we're going into the tippy, as the runners of this game like to call it. It is pretty much like the biggest choke point of the run for some of the best runners of this game. So it's you'll see a lot of like hard stars in there.
Yeah. See, this trick's not easy at all. Like, yeah, it's going for Lakitu bounce, yeah.
As you can see, it's a big choke point of the run.
Yeah.
Very tedious tricks that you need to try, and it takes a lot of skill to actually do this stage.
Let's hope he gets it this time. Very, very difficult though. As you can see, that long jump he does right near the end there, it's very precise. If he falls too short, he'll fall off.
So, like, usually you would long jump to that part and then just jump up to the star, but I'm going to opt out and actually go for a different strat for that star, which is good, because this game actually has many strategies for different stars, so there's always a backup to be done.
There we are. That's the backup.
Here we go!
So in this game, you require a lot of improv, because sometimes strats are just not going to hit, so you've got to be ready for that backup right away.
Actually enter at 12 o'clock, that actually completely stops the clock from moving at all, and it makes it much easier to get the rest of the stars on the stage. Okay, so we just have one last thing to do, and that's to go fight the final Bowser, which can still be tricky because the final throws are actually still pretty difficult.
Yeah, like full speed like swings and stuff, you've got like apparently 2 frames or so to get the correct throw, so it's not easy.
Yeah.
Excellent, excellent. Alright, time ends when he gets the final star, level, whatever it is.
Super Mario 64, 70 stars.
Yeah, thanks for watching.
Thank you so much, Washi, for that run.
Thanks for your help. It's been good.
All right, we did it.
We did it.
We got there. It's been 5 days of hard work from everyone, but we got there.
For a lot of us, it's been like 6 days.
Yeah.
Because we had to pack, set up.
I'd like to thank everyone who watched, who chatted, who helped out. Okay, my mic. Fix it later. And we raised a total of $3,066.52 for Beyond Blue. And I mean, we had a goal of 1,500, so that's, we doubled that, and then a little, which is really good. And so I don't know what else to say, so I'm just gonna like cut the stream. And start working on next year.
Mm-hmm. There's actually probably a few people we could actually thank. We could thank the University of South Australia for hosting our first leg of the marathon. Give them a round of applause, everybody. Yay. For AVCON, Adelaide's Video Game and Anime Festival, for hosting us here for the last 2 days. Give them a round of applause. And probably last, by no means least, Softman25 for making this event happen. Yeah, come on, we have to agree on a photo. Come on.
Let's get somewhere. Let's go against that wall. It's gonna be a lot better. We'll do that in a minute.
So yeah, we are going out
host,
now.
We'll host someone and then we're gonna piss off, okay?
Sweatshirt.
Who's live? You're not live. All right, let's host someone. I always scroll down the list. Is there any Australians? No, I don't know that person. They're Australian, but I don't know them. Yeah, I'll host you when you're standing there.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, Doom. That sounds fun. Let's go for Doom.
First speedrun test.
Yeah. Sure, why the hell not, right?
Yeah, it's type of Doom at
first. There's no one I know, so bugger them.
So they're getting hung.
Oh. Okay, cool. We're done.